What's up, guys? It's your homie Romy here. And today I'm here with some of my friends. We're gonna introduce them.
Maya.
Barack.
Amanda.
And what are we doing today, you guys?
Would you rather?
That being said, we're just gonna jump right in. Question number one. Would you rather only be able to listen to Nickelback songs for the rest of your life or read all 56 pages of iTunes terms and conditions every day for the rest of your life?
Nickelback.
Nickelback.
I'm going to Nickelback too.
iTunes.
To be honest, I think I would do iTunes because I would memorize it and be able to like recite it, and I can't listen to Nickelback.
That's smart. That's good.
Wait, you're actually so right.
Yeah. Like, if you guys think about it, like listen to Nickelback for the rest of your life.
You don't have to hear the words.
And and you get to read, which is like, you know, educational.
Yes, educational. Yeah.
Have your coffee in the morning, just read the pages. Question number two.
Woo! Trying to keep it hype in here.
Would you rather live like a king but have no friends and family, or be homeless with your friends and family?
Homeless with your friends and family.
Yeah.
Same.
Without my friends, I'm literally nothing.
I'm nothing.
We could be starving, we could be homeless, we could be broke.
Hey! Let's go.
I would honestly be homeless.
Finesse and hobos.
Finesse the streets.
Number three. Would you rather know when you're going to die or how you're going to die?
How?
Same. How?
How? Because if I actually knew when, I'd be so paranoid for
that. Yeah, same. I would literally be counting down. I only have 56 days to live.
Yeah.
I thought of getting your throat slit, like, or like burning or getting shot. So like you can like prevent it, you know? Like
that's what I thought too.
Buy one of those. I don't think they really make things for
like a cone for humans. But no, I would rather know how, because if I knew when, it would be too stressful. And yeah, you could prevent it if you knew how.
Number four. Would you rather be famous when you are alive and forgotten when you die, or unknown when you are alive but famous after you die?
Famous when I'm alive.
Yeah.
Like, my family can remember me. My legacy will live on. Thank you.
Question number five. Would you rather have an easy job working for somebody else or work for yourself but work incredibly hard?
Work for myself.
Yeah,
work for somebody else. You get paid so much for doing nothing. You work for a rich person.
I can't work under anyone else's rules.
You know, I have to
be my own boss or things don't work out.
And, like be, like, proud, like, that I'm doing something for myself but, like, working hard, you know?
Yeah.
Like, you're doing your thing. Like, you work hard for what you get.
Like, I need that money, I'm sorry.
I need that coin. Would you rather cheat on your partner or have your partner think you cheated even though you didn't? If you cheat on your partner, they don't know. If you don't choose that, then you're choosing that he thinks you cheated on somebody, but you never did.
Yeah, I would choose the second one.
Because then I would know that I'm still good.
Yeah, exactly.
But literally, one of my worst fears is having someone think that I cheated on them when I didn't. Like, seriously, I've said that out loud before. One of my worst fears. You just lose all trust with that person for no reason. Like, literally no reason. I don't want to cheat on
them.
I don't think I could cheat on so like.
You guys hit us up. We're loyal.
I know.
We're loyal. Question number seven. Would you rather sleep with the first person you see in the bar or the first person who hits on you at the bar?
This is a hard one.
Ooh. Because you don't know.
What if you're religious?
But what if the
first person you see is creepy too?
Like, I would walk in not looking at anyone until I heard someone attractive. I'd be like, who's there?
Hits on you, because at least it's consensual.
For that.
What if the first person that hits on you is like the weirdest person at the bar?
Basically, what I'm saying is hit on me and
hit on me and we are smashing.
I'll go with hit on me.
I don't know. Got hit on the street by some guy who got down on the floor and went bark, bark. Walking Hollywood Boulevard, guy got down on his knees and barked at us.
He literally went, "You guys are so attractive."
Answer.
Hit on me.
First person I look at.
I'm religious.
Next question. Would you rather be turned on every single time you see a man wearing a fedora or every single time you see a man wearing Crocs?
Fedora.
I think fedora too, because usually people that wear fedoras still are like fashionable people.
But do you ever see people wearing fedoras? That's the thing.
Yeah.
Do you see people wearing Crocs?
Usually people that wear Crocs sometimes are like cool.
Weird, yeah.
They're cool. My high school, like, Crocs were like the ish. Like,
okay, yeah,
like, thought it was funny.
One of my friends named Rachel, who I love dearly, wears Crocs and she's so cool. So, like, I feel like people who wear Crocs literally know that they're trying to be a meme, but people who wear fedoras go to coffee shops and like sit in the corner.
Ooh. Like, ooh, you're socially awkward.
Me, that's attractive.
I'm into that.
She's Crocs, but
Crocs.
Especially
yeah, yeah.
Gold. Gold Crocs.
Yellow Crocs for me.
Yellow?
Hit me up.
Yellow.
Oh. Yellow's like bold.
Like piss Crocs?
No, like a bright like lemon meringue.
Oh, lemon meringue yellow.
Sister did that.
lemon meringue Crocs, hit me up.
Next question. Would you rather have the best house in a terrible neighborhood or the worst house in a fancy neighborhood?
Worst house in a fancy neighborhood. Wait. I'm terrified of getting
killed. So scared. Every time Brooke hears a single sound, the whole house goes on locked. I'm like, oh my,
everyone get down.
It's a fancy neighborhood. Listen, it's not like the least fancy house there would be bad.
True. Exactly.
So I'm like, yeah, I would much rather the
best. It just says the worst house on that on a fancy street.
So that means that it's still fancy.
Oh.
Oh.
Last question. Would you rather receive or give a lap dance?
Give.
I don't have to be creative. I just sit there.
I want to give.
Yeah, I want to give too.
We're just still giving. I just want to give.
I just want to give.
Because I'm such a giving person.
So generous. Just you get a lap dance. You get a lap dance.
No matter what I do, it's going to be awkward. So I'll put little effort into it.
Okay, that is the end of the video. I hope you guys all enjoyed, and if you did, make sure to give it a
big thumbs up.
I will link everyone's social medias in the description, so make sure to go follow all them.
Romy and I just started a YouTube channel together. Go subscribe.
Hey. That being said, your homie Romy is peacing out. Bye guys.
I got the notification, yeah. Notification, yeah. Notification, yeah. Notification, yeah.